Welcome back to part 15 of our current revision. So today we will look at the projects, policies, frameworks and initiative in the context of environment and ecology subject. So chaliye aaj ka contents dekhenge. So the first topic is about the coral rehabilitation program. Second is green tax on the plane tickets. So which country has implemented this? Later we will look at the energy storage system roadmap. नेशनल गाइडलाइन फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एक्शन प्लान इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ हीट वेव. यहाँ पे हम हीट वेव इज वेदर इट इज कंसिडर्ड एज वन ऑफ द डिजास्टर और नॉट वो भी देख लेंगे. लेटर वी विल लुक एट द ग्रिड कनेक्टेड रूफ टॉप सोलर प्रोग्राम. ये प्रोग्राम क्या है, इसका टारगेट्स क्या है. लेटर वी विल लुक एट द डीप ओशन मिशन, नेशनल पॉलिसी एंड बायोफ्यूल प्रोजेक्ट श्योर. श्योर का मतलब क्या है, लाइक एंड इसका इनिशिएटिव कहां से आया है एंड व्हाट इज टारगेटेड एट, राइट. लेट अस लुक एट द इंडिया हैज प्लेज्ड फॉर द रिस्टोरेशन ऑफ 50 लाख नो हेक्टर्स ऑफ द डिग्रेडेड लैंड, राइट. रिस्टोरिंग दिस मच अमाउंट ऑफ द लैंड अंडर दिल्ली डिक्लेरेशन. सो दिल्ली डिक्लेरेशन क्या है वो भी देख लेंगे, ठीक है. लेट अस लुक एट द ड्राफ्ट नेशनल रिसोर्स एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी पॉलिसी. We have one energy efficiency mission under the 8 missions of National Action Plan for the Climate Change, right. Later we look at the Environment Ministry has released one Environment and Social Framework Management Framework in the context of coastal regions. Wo kya hai wo bhi dekh lenge. And final two topics are the Pace Settler Fund Program and Kerala has been started using the Miyawaki method. Method kya hai and why it is using. So, पहला टॉपिक कोरल रिहैबिलिटेशन प्रोग्राम. सो गल्फ ऑफ मन्नार मेरिन नेशनल पार्क, प्लीज डू रिमेंबर इट्स अ नेशनल पार्क, हैज बीन इंप्लीमेंटिंग दिस प्रोग्राम फ्रॉम 2002. व्हाई? टू रिहैबिलिटेट और टू इंक्रीज द कोरल्स एंड रिड्यूस द इंपैक्ट ऑफ द कोरल ब्लीचिंग, राइट. सो हियर दे आर यूजिंग द कॉन्क्रीट फ्रेम स्लैब्स मेथड. सो दिस इज काइंड ऑफ ए स्ट्रक्चर on which these corals are grown. For example, Acropola coral is one kind of such species that grows at 10 to 12 centimeters per year on these slabs. Already 8 square kilometers of area has been done in this area, okay. Please do remember corals are there in schedule 1 of the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So green tax on plane tickets. So France has imposed this from 2020. So the fund that has been coming from this from these taxes will be utilized for the green projects. So in India we have one scheme that is the National Clean Energy and Environment Fund. So ye fund kahan se aata hai? This comes from the clean energy cells that is being imposed on the coal generation. This is also in the news because the government is planning to remove this cess. Okay, we will update this whenever there is information on the same. The next topic is about the energy storage system roadmap. So India Smart Grid Forum, so this has prepared this roadmap. So in the roadmap क्या बताता है, in this report is said that what is the amount of the investment that are required to rely on renewable energy for the future, right. So वो कौन सी sectors में होंगे, either e-mobility or telecom sectors or data centers, because these kind of sectors are taking the huge amount of electrical energy. So that electrical energy is supposed to be generating from the renewable source of energy, right, that reduces the dependence on the carbon fuels or the fossil fuels. The next topic is about national guidelines for the preparation of action plan regarding the heat wave. So please do remember this is not under the list of 12 disasters that are there in the disaster response fund norms, right. So this heat wave generally occurs in the months of March to June and extends to July. So how it is defined, the heat wave, it is defined by MD. So if the temperature reaches 40 in the plain areas, 37 in the coastal areas, and 30 in the hilly areas. Okay. Grid connected rooftop solar program. So government has a target for installation of such rooftop solar projects of 40,000 megawatts by 2022. So that is the target. We have National Solar Mission, right? It's one of the mission under NAPCC. So its target kya hai? Like 150 gigawatts should be produced from the solar energy sources, right? Deep Ocean Mission. So this 80,000 crore planned to invest in this deep ocean deep ocean exploration capacities, right? Because it has huge amount of resources. For example, it has rare metals which are found in the deep oceans. Okay, so this been focused on the mining and underground vehicles, robotics and latest technologies. So we have one important United Nations convention. So this is UNCLOS, it's a own that stands for United Nations Convention on the Law of Sea. Okay, so this has come in 1982. This is otherwise called as Law of Sea. So this is the only international convention that gives the state jurisdiction that, okay, so ye country ka kahan se kahan tak hai limitations, like uska maritime boundaries kya hai. So this will decide. The next topic is about the national policy and biofuel. So iska target kya hai? To reach 20% blending of ethanol in petrol, 5% in biodiesel by 2030. Okay, so recently there has been news. So what is this program? This program, in the first generation, takes the additional food material or the additional food sources and utilizing that to produce the biofuels. We have already discussed about the four generations under this policy, like from starting from the food-based biofuels to genetically modified microorganisms, right? Project SURE. SURE ka matlab kya hai? Sustainable Resolution. So this project SURE is being launched by the Union Textiles Ministry along with the Clothing Manufacturing Association of India, United Nations in India and IMG Reliance. Okay, so what is it aims for? It aims for reducing the that particular industry specific carbon emissions and reducing the inputs like the water and water management, right, to reach the sustainable targets. Okay, so recently in the CBD, that's the Convention on the Biodiversity, we have one nation that has occurred in the India. There was one declaration called as New Delhi Declaration. So to implement that declaration, India has now pledged to restore 50 lakh hectares of degraded land by 2030. Okay, so for that particular initiative, we have Center for Excellence to be established at Dehradun. So what is the aim? It aims at the restoring of the degraded land, right? So we have already discussed about the Kampa and regarding the same fund, how it is distributed between the states, right? So 90% to the states and 10% that stays with the central government. Draft National Resource Efficiency Policy. So in this policy has built on 6R principles. Here 6 R's are, we already know about 3 R's, that is reduce, reuse, recycle, right? And the other three R's are refurbish, redesign and remanufacture. Okay, so this envisages the future with sustainable and equitable economical growth. So it has set one targets to track the progress of how efficiently these resources are being utilized. So for this same purpose, there is one institutional setup that is called as the National Resource Efficiency Authority. And in this one of the features of this policy is that there is a shared responsibility of all the stakeholders. Remember, we have one mission, National Mission for Enhanced Energy Efficiency, as one of the missions of 8 missions, that is on climate change, National Action Plan on Climate Change. Next topic is Environment Ministry has released one framework, that is the Environment and Social Framework. So, ye framework kiske liye use karta hai? Using this framework, they will judge whether a particular infrastructure in the coastal area can be given a clearance or not. Okay. So, this is a part of the World Bank funded program, that is ENCORE, stands for Enhancing Coastal and Ocean Resource Efficiency Program. So, this is implemented by the different, different organizations, that is a society for of the integrated coastal management, our ministry, environment ministries, national project management unit, ICZMP and ENCORE program, we have seen this, right? Pay settler fund program. Pehle program kya hai? This is the program that is a kind of fund that is has been in association with USA, we have set up in 2015. Ye kiske liye set up hua hai? To provide funds for the early stage off-grid green programs, right? Off-grid ka matlab kya hai? For example, off-grid solar panels use karke energy generation karte hai na? So those kind of projects. So Ministry of New and Renewable Energy has given grants for new such four projects, okay, under this scheme. The final topic, that is the Kerala to turn to Miyawaki method. So Miyawaki is Japanese botanist ka naam hai. So he has come up with this particular method where, so in this backyard, so he had kept planting samples in very small area. So because of this continuous competition between those in this particular species there, where because of those restricted species, they grow very much fast, nearly 10 times faster. So this has been developed by this Japanese botanist. So now Kerala government has taken up this method and they are coming up to introduce this in government offices, premises, residential complexes, right? Okay, so in different areas to aid the afforestation program, especially in the urban areas. So this also aids in reducing the urban heat island effect. So let us meet in the next topic. Till then, please continue with your preparation. Lage raho continuously. Stop not till your goal is reached, as Swami Vivekananda has said. So till then, take care. Thank you.